If you don't have a Steak and Shake near you, you're missing out. The fast-ish food joint specializes in hamburgers – they call them steak burgers – and is one of the fastest-growing restaurants in the US, with over 550 across the country. It's not just a fad, though, as Steak and Shake has been around since the 1930s. So what took them so long to make an impact nationally? Here's a look at what diehard fans don't even know about Steak and Shake. The start of the slogan. Steak and Shake founder Gus Belt was a bit of a showman. When he opened the first Steak and Shake in 1934, he decided to prove how fresh his steak burgers were by hauling a wheelbarrow of fresh meat through the store and then grinding it right in front of the customers. That sounds kind of horrifying, actually, but it led to the famous Steak and Shake slogan, "In sight, it must be right." Also in sight? The milkshake machines, which he put in the front window so people driving by would be enticed to stop by. They have their own language. Another Steak and Shake slogan flashes in red at every location. It looks like a tricky tongue twister – Tacoma Sack. So where did Belt come up with this? Well, he didn't. A restaurant in Denver, Colorado called Rocky Belt actually pioneered the slogan Tacoma Sack as a suggestion that hungry patrons order pickup. You know, take home a sack? When Belt appropriated the slogan, he simply took out the dashes from the original spelling and the familiar Tacoma Sack slogan was born. There was a Steak and Shake Civil War. In 2013, the Steak and Shake brand devolved into civil war when 50 franchise owners banded together to fight back against their corporate masters, who were demanding that all franchises lower their prices to adhere to a new $4 value meal menu. The rebellious franchises claimed that the drop in prices would lead to hundreds of thousands of dollars in lost revenue.
What are the odds, Mike? All four meals under $4 going to the same table?
Yep.
The results were a mixed bag for the franchises. While some reached a settlement out of court with parent company Biglari Holdings, at least one franchise was forced to pay damages after unhappy patrons brought their own lawsuit, alleging they had been charged $5 for food that was advertised as being on the $4 menu. You could say they were playing for high stakes. It's changed hands several times. When founder Gus Belt died in 1954, his wife Edith took over the company. In 1969, though, she sold the 50 or so Steak and Shake locations to a company called Longchamps. That was just the start of a string of buyouts. The Franklin Corporation bought Steak and Shake in 1971, then sold it to E.W. Kelly and Associates in 1981. Company head Ed Kelly decided to return the franchise to its roots of fresh meals, made to order, and eventually expanded the chain to where it is now under the new parent company Biglari Holdings. It inspired Shake Shack. If you're a diehard fan of Shake Shack, you have Steak and Shake to thank for your favorite spot. Yes, it's true, Shake Shack founder Danny Meyer told the New York Times that his career path started at the Steak and Shake in St. Louis when he was just a teen, saying, "I spent a lot of my weekend nights as a teenager at Steak and Shake, and those parking lot experiences hanging out with friends were inspirational in my desire to create a burger joint that would bring people together." They say that imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, but in this case, it's also the yummiest. Roger Ebert was their biggest fan. You might like Steak and Shake. You might even love Steak and Shake, but you, friend, are no Roger Ebert. The famous movie critic gave the restaurant two thumbs up and waxed poetically in prose usually reserved for an Oscar-winning film. He said if the Pope asked for a good spaghetti joint, he'd recommend the Chili Mac or Chili Three Ways, both Steak and Shake specialties. His love affair with the burger joint started on the campus of the University of Illinois when he was just 3 or 4 years old and continued throughout his life. Ebert wrote in his loving ode to the restaurant in 2009 that if he were on death row, his last meal would be from Steak and Shake. He finally succumbed to cancer in 2013 after a lengthy battle. Let's hope he had one more steak burger for the road. Thanks for watching! Click the MASHED icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out all this cool stuff we know you'll love, too!